Hello guys, how are you doing? So in this quick tutorial, I'm going to show you how you can improve your Substance Painter workflows because I realized my system is really slow because I have a low GPU. So I'll show you how you can kind of like improve it. So the first thing you want to do is to make sure your system is always on high performance because you're going to be using a GPU intensive work. So here I'm going to select the battery and I'll right click and I'll go to power and sleep options. When that opens up, make sure it's on the best performance so that you can actually use more power just to help your GPU. Now, my GPU is kind of low, and to do that, I'll just use a quick shortcut. I'll do a Windows R, and I'll type DXDIAG, which just simply means DirectX Diagnostics, and I'll just press OK. This should open up the DirectX. Now, I have about 20 gig RAM. That's awesome. But for my display, it's quite low for Substance Painter. So this is 128 megabytes. So I'll just go ahead and close that. So usually what happens is if you have real memory intensive work, Substance Painter is going to crash because it needs enough time to finish that action. And your system might decide and say, hey, you know what? You're actually slowing down. You're using more of the GPU and it needs to shut down. So that's why it will crash. Another quick tip if you're using Substance Painter is to turn off any layers you don't necessarily need. So I'm not working with these layers right now, so I turned them off. And for this example, this asset is from the Substance Painter tutorials, which is quite awesome. So that's where I got this asset. This is not my asset. I'm just learning and I'm using this asset. So what you can do is you can turn off any sections you're not using. For instance, this asset has the legs and also has the body part. I'm not working on the legs right now, so I'll just turn off the legs. And again, a quick tip is to turn off the layers you don't need. So we'll just go ahead and turn that off. And then turn off any basic layers. So if I click on the body and go back here, I'll just turn off the layers I don't need specifically. That actually improves the performance. So another way we can improve the performance, which might not necessarily be for Substance Painter, but for the Windows system entirely, is to change our appearance and adjust to best performance. So I'll just press the Windows key and I'll just say adjust for the appearance. Yeah, there it is. So here, and it's like mine is actually set to adjust for best performance. Go ahead and set it to that and click OK, and hopefully this might improve. Another way to do this is to set the performance of a specific app when you're using it. So for instance, you have a game or you have a 3D modeling software like Blender or even Substance Painter. Like for this example, you could just set it to turn on high performance for that app, just like we did with the battery. So let's go ahead and do that. So I'll just press Windows key and I'll just say graphics. So this is going to open up the graphics settings, and when the graphics settings opens up, we can browse an app to add it. So I've already added Substance Painter, so I'll just go ahead and click browse, and let's go ahead and go to program files and say for instance we want to add Blender. I'll just look for the executable like so and click on add, and then under the options, this is going to set it to high performance, and I'm going to save that. So anytime I'm using Blender and Substance Painter, this is going to, you know, turn on high performance. So all you have to do is just go to browse and locate where you've installed that software, and then you can set that software and then improve it. So hopefully that might help. Right, so let's go ahead and see how we can set up and increase our timeout detection and recovery. So first, to do that, we'll actually head off to our Windows registry keys. Please note, do not mess with your system registries or delete any files. This might actually damage your operating system and you might need to reinstall your operating system. So disclaimer, if you know what you're doing, follow along. If you don't want to tamper or don't destroy anything or don't want to mess up your system, you can just run away. So let's go ahead and do that. So I'll press Windows R, and here I'll just type regedit, R-E-G-E-D-I-T. That's the registry editor. That's R-E-G-E-D-I-T. And let's return the return. Let's press the return key, and I'll click yes. So now that that's open up, yours might actually be collapsed like so. I'll just drop that, and maybe it's like this. So let's just go ahead and open that. So the first thing we'll do is to go to the HKey local machine. So I'll click on HKey local machine and I'll just go to system right here. I'm going to click on system. I'm going to go to current control set right here. With the current control set, let's look for control and click that as well. And the next we're going to look for graphics drivers. So just press G like so. and it'll actually be on graphics drivers. So I'll just click on that graphics drivers. So what we are actually going to do next is to create the TDR delay and TDRDI delay. So we can actually set those values that will tell our system to wait when there's a lot of computation on the GPU. It's going to wait for a few minutes rather than wait for the seconds that Microsoft originally gives for GPU operations. So here I'm going to just right click and I'm going to say new. I'll do dword 32-bit value, and let's just call that capital T D R capital D E L A Y. TDR delay, just like that. And next we're going to right click and I'll click on modify and switch this to decimal so I can set a decimal value. So I'm going to give it 240. That's going to give it 4 minutes. So 60 is 1 minute, 120 is 2 minutes, and 240 should be 4 minutes. So I'm just going to set it to 4 minutes. That might actually be a long time, but I'm going to set it. The default that Substance wants you to set this is just a minute, that's 60 seconds, but I'm going to set mine to 4 minutes. And I'm going to test it. If it's too much, if it's too long, I can just switch it back to 2 minutes max. So next, let's go ahead and repeat that step again. So let's right click, click on new and dword 32-bit value. And let's call this capital T D R D I capital D E L A Y, like so. Let's right click, go to modify, and let's go to decimal, and I'll set that to 240 as well. And the delay means TDR means timeout delay detection, and it's a graphics for a graphics processor unit. So with these set, what I'm going to do is to reset the system. We need to restart our system because the BIOS is going to set this value when the system is booting, not when it's live. Now, this next tip, we're going to see how we can improve the graphics memory. So if I just right click, or let's just use our trick, I'll do a Windows R and I'll do a DXDIAG just to show you how we can check out your video memory. So individuals who have a very powerful laptop, you can actually see that their video memory is super sound. So let's see that. So my display memory is 128 megabytes, which is incredibly poor for gaming and for heavy 3D work with use such as Substance Painter. That's the essence. That's why I'm even doing this video in the first place. So let's see how you can improve or increase this display memory, because my system memory is about 20 gigabytes for my RAM and the shared memory is 10 gigabytes. Now, I tried this method. Personally, it did not work for me. So you might actually be lucky and this works for you. So let me show you how you can improve your virtual memory. Again, disclaimer, you might actually mess up your system, so be careful when you're doing this. So we'll just do a Windows R to open up the run. So I'll just do type regedit, just like we did earlier on, and I'll just click yes. So when this opens up, I'll just go ahead and close this. Yours might be collapsed. So the first thing to do is to click this drop down arrow. I'll go to hotkey local machine and I'll go to system. I'll just open up the system, and from here I'm going to go to software, just right here. And not software, what am I going? Hkey local. So I'm on hotkey local machine and software, not system. So I'll go to software. There it is. And right here, I'll just open up the Intel dropdown. So what I need to do right now is to create a new folder called GMM. So I'll just right click on Intel. I'll just go to new and I'll just create a key and I'll just call that DMM. So with that DMM folder created, I'm going to select it. Make sure you're selecting that DMM folder. I'm going to right click and I'll create new and I'll create a dword 32 value. And next, what I'm going to type in is dedicated. Now note the caps. It starts with a capital D and I'll do a segment, capital S. And then I'll do size with capital S as well. So once that has been created, I'll just double click that and click on decimal. And just, we'll just type in 512. Basically, I'm trying to set my virtual memory to to 512 to boost it. Now, I've tried this, like I said, on my own system, and sadly, it did not work for me because I heard Intel has changed the way you could actually do this. It used to be that it worked, but these days it does not work. But you might actually try your system in case you're using an older version, and good luck. If it does, it means you've actually boosted it. Now, if for instance, if you have like a 10 gigabyte shared memory, you could actually set this to, let's say, 2048, right? You can set this to 2048. I can actually set this to this value on my own because I actually have a shared memory. So with that, you can actually close this and reboot the system. I tried this. It didn't work for me. So sad to me, but I just pray and hope it works for you. Now, if we've set this up properly, if we open up Substance Painter, it should open up without showing up that warning it shows. So let's go ahead and see this. So Substance Painter has opened up and it hasn't given us any warning about the TDR delay, but it's actually telling us about that 128 MB is detected right here at the bottom. You can actually see that at the bottom of the screen. It's telling us 128 MB detected. So that means the setting has not worked. It hasn't improved my VRAM and it's going to stay that way. So the best thing for me to do right now is to invest in a system that has a very nice GPU so that I can actually enjoy using the software. Now, this final tip is going to be for someone who wants to get into graphic design or heavy 3D modeling, unlike me that just has a system and I have to like kind of like force my system to work with Painter. So what I just mean is, if you have a budget or you're trying to get a new system, if you're on a system, a Windows operating system, the one of the best platforms you can use is to actually use a laptop that has an Intel Core minimal of i3 processor, and you can use an AMD Ryzen. So you can use Ryzen 3. It's actually known to perform very nice, and you can use any of the NVIDIA or NVIDIA GeForce GTX 1060 or NVIDIA Quadro M2000, or you can use an AMD Radeon, or you can use the Radeon RX 6700 if you're actually up for it. So that's one of the best systems to use. If you're on a Mac, you can use the MacBook Pro, the 2019 or 2020 version. And your CPU is going to be, you can use an Intel Core i7 or the i9 for the MacBook Pro 2020. But for your GPU, you need to have something, at least you need to have AMD Radeon Pro, the 5300M. And you can actually have a RAM of 8 gig. For optimal, you could actually increase your RAM to 32 gig or any higher value. So the key players here are AMD, NVIDIA, and these are actually the best companies out there presently that you know, are really great for GPU. So you can invest in those systems and hopefully you don't have to actually turn everything off. You can just be running on full force. So if you like the video, do give it a thumbs up, and I'll see you in the next quick tip.